This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how operating budgets are used by merchandising organizations and often called retail organizations. And we'll do a little bit of contrasting with manufacturing companies as well, so you see the difference between a manufacturing company operating budget and a merchandising company operating budget. Merchandising organizations purchase finished goods, so they don't actually produce the goods, somebody else does, and the merchandising organizations typically then will buy those goods either from wholesale companies or it could be from the manufacturers directly. And then merchandising companies will sell these goods to often retail or wholesale customers. Since retail companies do not tend to make the goods, or if they do, they do it on a very small level. Maybe there's some assembly involved, but that's usually about it. They do not need any production or production-related budgets. The merchandising companies instead utilize a merchandise purchases budget. So it's not a direct materials purchases budget. There are no direct materials or direct labor or manufacturing overhead budgets like in a manufacturing company. Instead, the merchandising companies are preparing a merchandise purchases budget typically. And the merchandise purchases budget will estimate the units of merchandise that need to be purchased along with the cost per unit. Here are the typical budget schedules that relate to a merchandising organization. Of course, you're going to have a sales budget where we estimate what we think our sales will be, and that's very similar to what you'll see in a manufacturing setting as well. We need to estimate what we think our sales of products will be and the revenues associated with that. And then, of course, since we're selling product, we need to put together a merchandise purchases budget that will be driven by that sales budget. So if we think we're going to, if we're a sporting goods store, for example, and we think we're going to sell, say, 50 baseball bats during a quarter, then we need to factor that in and work it into our merchandise purchases budget. So the sales budget drives the merchandise purchases budget. We also then, to the left, see the selling and administrative budget, and that's for example, our labor costs. If we have a retail store, the employees that are in that store that we have to pay, that is part of our labor cost. It would include things like the rent on the retail store. It would include things like the insurance on the retail store. All of those things would be factored into the selling and administrative budget. Then we also have a capital expenditures budget. And this, again, is similar to in a manufacturing setting where we would want to budget for any long-term assets that we anticipate purchasing, things like computer equipment, maybe we need a forklift for the warehouse, whatever it might be. If it's a long-term asset, it would go into that capital expenditures budget. Then all of this information feeds into the cash budget, so we can take a look at what our cash inflows will be and what our cash outflows will be for a period of time. And what we're trying to get at there is to make sure that we don't run short of cash. And if we do see a temporary shortage of cash because of a lag from the purchases of merchandise between that and the sales of merchandise, then we would need to go out and find an alternative source of financing for cash until we actually sell those goods and get the cash from our customers. And as I mentioned, all these budgets feed in to these bottom budgets, and that includes the income statement. We'd want to put together a budgeted income statement for our merchandising company and a budgeted balance sheet. Lastly, we want to take a look at what service organization operating budgets look like. And of course, service organizations provide services, not tangible goods, or at least that's not a big portion of their business. And so we don't need to worry so much about the merchandise purchases budget that you would see in a merchandising company setting or production budgets that you would see in a manufacturing setting. The focus in the first bullet point here for a service organization is on projected sales revenue from services that we provide to our customers, and then the labor that's necessary to provide those services. Labor tends to be one of the biggest costs for a service organization, so that's going to be a significant component when it comes to putting together an operating budget for our service organizations. Let's take, for example, a company that provides landscape maintenance services for commercial buildings. So we're a company that goes out, we cut the lawn, we trim the trees, we take care of, maybe we plant flowers, we take care of the landscape maintenance work for commercial buildings. Much of that work, in fact, the majority of that work, the costs associated with that work, will be related to labor. we're going to have a fairly large labor force, and so that's going to be the significant cost associated with our business. And so we're going to want to map that out really carefully in our operating budgets, and that's why I say it's a significant component of operating budgets for service organizations. So again, service organizations don't need production or merchandise purchases budgets. We're focusing on labor, really, in addition to the sales revenue. Last two bullet points here, some other key pieces of information for service organizations, not-for-profit organizations like churches or charitable organizations or school districts also use operating budgets for planning and control purposes. And I have a separate video that describes the planning and control phase of budgeting. So it's important that not-for-profit organizations put these budgets together as well. And budgeting is critical when you look at governmental agencies and others as well, that budgeting is critical because it serves as the guidelines that the organization must follow and the legal authority for the organization to make those expenditures. So if there's no budget in a government setting, it's very difficult, if not impossible, to actually have legal expenditures. So they're required in those organizations to have operating budgets.